Okay, everyone. Dad's plane just landed.
Oh, Lord.
Calm down, babe. It's going to be all right.
Steve's right. It's going to be fine. We just need to have a little faith.
You know what? If you find some faith, throw some out, because right now I ain't feeling this.
And where is Eva? I don't want to do this without her.
I don't know where she is, Mom, but I'd rather be with her instead of here.
For as long as I can remember, I've tried to live my life trying to make people like me. I thought that if I did the things that I thought they wanted me to do, or said the things that I thought they wanted me to say, or acted like I thought they wanted me to act, that ultimately I'd be accepted and loved. And I know in my mind that the only one that matters is Jesus, but don't I feel it? Why do I still feel helpless? I know the greater one lives in me, but why can't I be strong? Jesus, I can't be like you. I can't forgive and turn the other cheek. Why are you bringing me to this now? Why couldn't you just let us get through this holiday and just leave well enough alone?
This is a bad idea. Y'all should have asked me first. And you have no right to just come in and invite this man just to come in and...
Look, I was just trying to help. He is our father.
That man deserted us when we were kids. I have no desire to meet him right now. Besides, Steve's my pops as far as I'm concerned.
Whoa. Look, Chris. Hey, I appreciate the compliment, but this isn't about me. Greg is your biological father, and that position deserves respect.
Man, respect is something you earn.
And I raised my children to respect their elders. But that's not the issue. Olivia, you overstepped your bounds. How could you invite that man into this house? Listen. It's just really bothering me that he wants to come here. He left me without excuse, went off talking about he wanted to get some milk and never came back. I declare, I really don't want that man anywhere near my house.
He left me too, you guys? You all need to learn to forgive and move on. Besides, it's not like I'm asking you to be the man's best friend.
Look, if that man walks through that door, I'll kill him. In Jesus' name, I'll kill him.
Hey, look, Chris, you need to watch how you're using the Lord's name in this house. It ain't like that.
Thanks, Steve. Guys, this is a serious matter. I really feel you should think hard and pray about this.
But how did you find him anyway?
Well, remember Denise, my friend?
Yeah.
He called her, tracked us down. I guess he figured she'd know where we'd be.
That sounds just like him. Why he wouldn't look for me himself. You know, he's always been a coward.
Mom, Dad's saved now.
Look, God would never accept that man after all he's done. He's a liar, a cheat, an adulterer, and he left his children. Come on, man.
Chris. Christ died, was buried, and rose again for all of our sins. Even the ones you haven't kept track of.
My face was all that.
Hey, Chris, can I bow a vow? We couldn't hear you.
Look, let me tell you. My sins are nowhere the level of his.
Look, I know this is tough, Chris, but we all have sinned and fallen short. You are no more righteous than he is.
Well, how can you expect us to take that man back? Where was he when I raised Olivia, Chris, and Eva? Not here. And I had to raise them all by myself. And three jobs at that.
Look, May, I know it wasn't easy. But with the Lord's help, you managed. And with the Lord's help, you can manage this meeting.
And Mom, don't forget, the spirit of unforgiveness hinders God's blessings upon this house.
Well, aren't you the special one? So full of forgiveness and love. You don't remember, that man took your college money to fly out of this town.
I remember.
Yeah, and what about all the other stuff he did?
What y'all doing in here anyway? Why don't y'all go outside somewhere and play? Sick of looking at you. Y'all go on, go outside and play. What, you got something to say? Say it then. Yeah, that's what I thought. Little girl's supposed to be pretty and smart. You ain't either one.
Listen, I'm with Chris, Olivia. There is too much pain associated with that man, and all he's gonna do is just shed light on it. I don't know if I can deal with that right now.
But honey, it has to come to light for the healing to take place.
Steve, the only person who's gonna benefit from this meeting is that man. And I'll be honest with you, I don't wanna give him the satisfaction. He needs to suffer. Oh, so what if he's sorry? He should be sorry. Just ran off with that woman and married her. And he just lied to me about it.
Mom, this is still eating you up inside. Can't you see that?
Well, yeah.
And who cares about his satisfaction? I'm thinking about my satisfaction here.
Well, what satisfaction you gonna get?
Okay. The satisfaction that I was obedient to God's word. The satisfaction that I've forgiven my father just as my heavenly father has forgiven me. The satisfaction that I can move on with my life if I just let go. Mom, you want revenge.
You all right, I want revenge. That man's gonna get away with murder and I have to sit back and take it. Listen here, I'm tired of that, and I was tired of it then. I don't even think I can handle it anymore. I am tired of it.
I know the Bible says that vengeance is the Lord's, but I want to make him pay for all the pain he caused this family. I mean, it's not like he forgot my birthday or something. I could forgive that. He left us. He left us! As a Christian, how do you deal with something like that?